So my name's Greg Perks. I'm from Halifax originally. So I'm working in Manchester at CTI Digital. So I'm a lead Drupal developer. I've been working here for about 4 years now. Prior to that, I was working in Leeds. And prior to that, I was working in Bradford. So I'm slowly moving my way across the country. Straight out of university, I was working in Tenerife for an agency out there. But yeah, at the minute I'm working in Manchester and enjoying it very much. It is my first sprint. I've been working in a logistical capacity. So I've opened my laptop for 10 minutes today. But outside of that, I've been trying to get things to run smoothly. So I've been dealing with the food, the drinks, the coffee machines broken down. just trying to make sure that the things that might cause problems for other people are problems, and then that everybody else can just carry on with their day as smoothly as possible. It has met my expectations. I'm really pleased with the number of people that turned up, and I hope that we have another one again sometime soon. Make sure that you engage with the community. If there's any meetups in your local area, try and involve those as much as possible. Plan as early as possible. Make sure that anything that possibly could go wrong has been considered. So think about health and safety. Is there a first aider on site? Think about where you're going to host it. Is there any considerations about around where you're hosting the event? Does parking, transport? At the event today, for example, people have travelled from York, Leeds, from down south, and we've had questions like, where can I park, where's the nearest car park, those kind of things. If you can think about all those questions ahead of time and give people that information, then you'll make sure that it runs much smoother than it would otherwise. Just go, I think a lot of people have the view that they won't necessarily get something out of that meetup, so it might be something that you're very familiar with already. There will be things that get discussed at that meetup that you aren't familiar with. I was talking to a colleague the other day, and he said to me that every single meetup he's been to, he's always learnt something, regardless of whether he was familiar with that particular topic or not. If you get a large enough group there, there's always chat and collaboration, and people share ideas and that. Yeah, so the last meetup that I went to, we were discussing GDPR, and there was a lot of things around that where we were asking questions, and people became really engaged in that, even though it might not necessarily seem like a particularly interesting topic of conversation. I think there was a lot of confusion around that, I think it helped a lot of people, and they asked questions that they might have otherwise felt a little bit stupid for asking, maybe. I think meetups can be meetups by their very nature are very welcoming, and people welcome what would otherwise be considered perhaps a silly question. I'd definitely recommend people to go along. So I think working in a bigger agency, it's much more structured. In a smaller agency, it's very much hands-on. Any problem that arises, the expectation is that you will be able to fix that problem, whether that's a logistical issue or a technical issue. You sort of wear many more hats, but in a much less focused manner. Whereas when you work for a bigger agency, I think your responsibilities are much more specific, and it allows you to really focus on those in a detailed way and become much more proficient in those. So for me, for example, I'm a line manager and also a lead developer as well. And working at CTI has allowed me to focus on those exclusively and become a bit of a subject matter expert in those. So I think that's probably the key difference. So at CTI there's two other people that are doing the same job as me. There's a third person on the way, hopefully. Every week we have a meeting, we get together, discuss ideas, discuss ways of working. It's very collaborative the way that we do it. And yeah, I think that's one of the things in an agency, it is very collaborative. I think there's a perception of large agencies that it can be very prescriptive, but I've not found that to be the case. In my experience, it is very collaborative and people are very open to new ideas and different ways of working. With us, for example, we were recently ISO accredited, so we have a QMS document internally, and everybody is allowed to feed into that particular document, and that defines the processes at CTI and how the company works structurally. And we welcome anybody from junior developers all the way up to the manager director to feed into that and help define how the company runs. 10, 12 years ago, people would have written a very bespoke system to deal with a very specific problem, but with open source projects like Drupal, they're written by a community of people who work in a much more generalist fashion, but there's so many different people working on the project that it enables you to look at very complex issues. So with London, for example, with the GLA website, the Mayor and the London Assembly were concerned about engagement and engaging with people within London, so that included things like multimedia, forums, you know, getting people to actually actively engage with the website. And in the past, that might have involved building a custom forum, building a custom CMS for people to manage that, whereas with Drupal, you can leverage Drupal as a system, use a lot of contributed modules to get you a large part of the way there as far as building a website, and then add some custom features and functionality on top. And if it's built in the right way, you can then take those custom features and contribute those back into the community as well, to make sure that you're working towards the same goal as everyone else. I think a lot of people might have a perception that large agencies are quite selfish in their approach, and I don't think that is necessarily the case. I think anybody that works within a Drupal team needs to be aware of the open source community, because ultimately the open source community is the community that actually provides the tools and services that we use as a business. So I think for us not to feed into that, it would be very foolish. And you know, it's, although Drupal is a community, it's a very close-knit community, and people are very aware of other people, and I think your standing within that community can be affected by not actively contributing to it. So now that we've moved more towards using Drupal 8, I think getting familiar with Symfony is a really important tool in your skill set. Object-oriented code is another important thing, so becoming familiar with that. We're moving away from the procedural code of Drupal 7 now, so that's probably not something that's as desirable as it once was in the past. It will still be a desirable quality for the next few years at least, I would imagine, but just getting familiar with object-oriented code and those ways of working. If you're a back-ender, if you're a front-ender, internally at CTI we use SAS and we use the BEM block element modifier way of working with CSS. Some other companies might use a different methodology, but I don't think a lot do. So that's just becoming familiar with those would help you in that perspective as well. An understanding of Git would be beneficial as well. You can go to github.com, sign up for an account. There's documentation on the website that will help you understand how to commit code to a repository. With an open source project, generally speaking, code is committed to a repository and it's shared with other people. So becoming familiar with that would be a key asset as well. And you'd be very surprised how many people that we do interview that are unfamiliar with those principles.